Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Chloe, for those of you that are new. And if you are new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button below and then the little notification bell so you know when I upload a new video. Please hit that like button and please comment below and let me know who you are and where you're watching from. Also, at the end of the video, if you still have questions about what my subject is about, please leave a comment below and I will either try to respond to those comments or make another video if there's too many comments, and I will try to answer those comments for you. So today I would like to talk about DoorDash. A lot of you have said that it sounds like I'm saying DoorDash, your door something, I don't know. You guys aren't getting the name right, so it's DoorDash. They work like Uber Eats and Grubhub. So the most common question I get is, how does it work for a driver? So if you are interested, if you're out of work and you're looking to make some extra money, DoorDash, I would highly recommend doing DoorDash because, yes, it is wear and tear on your car. Yes, you have to pay a lot for gas, and all that is fine and dandy, but actually not. But you can make some really good money doing DoorDash. Sometimes I can make up to 20 bucks an hour, depending on the time of day that I go, the day that I go, how busy it is, if there's events that are going on, like maybe it's a football game on a Sunday that people are staying home and they don't want to go out and get their food and they want their food delivered, those days are busier as well. So getting started into DoorDash, what you want to do if you want to become a DoorDasher, go to DoorDash.com and there should be a link in there that says become a Dasher or I want to become a Dasher or something like that. I made notes, sorry. And then go through the steps that they take you through. You will have to download it onto your phone as an app, and they will want a copy of your driver's license. So you take a picture of your driver's license. I think they asked for the insurance on your car to make sure that you are insured. And there may be other things that I don't remember because I did it. I started back in April, or I signed up for it in September, in March actually. And so once you go through the steps and they have approved you, then you have the Dasher app on your phone, which is that little white circle with the red thing in the middle. It says Dasher. And once you have received and completed one Dash order, or one Dash shift, if you will, they will send you for free a red Dasher bag, which is insulated on the inside, and they will send you one of these, which is a red card. It's a dummy credit card that is for DoorDash orders only. You cannot use this for your own personal use. So let's say you, like for instance, Taco Bell, I have to use this DoorDash red card to sort of pay for the customer's order, but it's not coming out of my account. It's coming out of DoorDash's account, and then they charge the customer appropriately. So they will send that to you once you have completed one order, or maybe one shift or something like that. So they know you're serious that you want to become a Dasher. So how it works is, I don't get paid hourly. I get paid per order. So they have things like peak pay, they have a base pay, and then the customer can tip you. Most of the time, the customers tip. Sometimes not so well. Sometimes they don't, and it's up to the customer's discretion if they want to tip, if they have money to tip, or whatever. Maybe they think that we get paid by the hour, but we don't. So if you do use DoorDash to order food, please tip your drivers because they don't get paid an hourly wage. You are allowed to decline an order for whatever reason. You might need a bathroom break. It might be too far away. You might not think it pays enough. But you want to try and limit how many orders you decline, because that'll affect your ratings, which I'll go through with you in a minute. And you can also look up your earnings as well. So you have 30 seconds to accept an order once they give it to you on your phone, or and or you can decline it. And if you decline it, you have 90 seconds to hit the once you hit the decline button, you have 90 seconds to give a reason why. And they have a list of different reasons why you want to decline your order, from the order's too far away, or the location is too far away, I don't want to accept this order, it doesn't pay enough, I need a bathroom break, an emergency, something else, whatever. There's a list of things that they have you do when you click on that, and you send it into them, and then they send you another order. So how it works. So starting a Dash shift. So what you want to do is, once you've downloaded the app on your phone, you click this little button here, and it'll bring you up to this little map here. And they are divided into different boundaries. So mine automatically, I don't know why it went to Columbia Heights, nowhere near there. Mine usually goes to the U of M in Minneapolis area, because I'm close to there. But I usually like to stay in the Plymouth area, which is where I used to live. So I know that area very well. You can choose which area you want to go into. So at this time, I told you about peak pay. So at this time, if you look down here, it says until 9 o'clock, you can make an extra dollar per order between now and 9 o'clock. So to give you an idea of, why is this like this? Okay, there we go, okay. Oh, actually, I can do like that. Okay. So to give you an idea, once you hit those three, let me go back a little bit. Okay, so once you hit these three bars on the top, then it'll bring you into this menu. So you can either hit Dash, you can hit, what does that say? Schedule. You can schedule a Dash for later. You can check your earnings. You can go to the ratings. And then all these information about your account, account details, your red card, like if you've lost your red card, you click on that, click on settings, you can log out, and you can invite friends and get extra money. So if I go into my earnings, this will tell you, once it comes up, my phone is running kind of slow and I really need it to speed up. So this is how much I made today. So $61.76, and then it gives you a bar graph on the bottom as to how every week that you've dashed, how much you've made. And then you can scroll up and see it's divided into the weeks and the months. So if we click on that, that goes into this week's dashes, which today, their dash weeks are from Monday through Sunday. So I dashed today. So my DoorDash pay for today was $40.50. My customer tips were $21.26. My active time, which means how much time I was on that I wasn't pausing my orders, was just under 3 hours. My total dash time was just over 4 hours, and I had 9 deliveries. And then you can go into your dashes per day, and hopefully this will speed up. So like on this one, it starts at the very bottom. So the first orders that you do are down here on the bottom, and they go to the very last order. So my last order was at Chipotle. And I had a peak pay of $2. I don't know if you can see that. If it's glaring, I'm sorry. The base pay was $3. And the customer tipped me $3. So I made $8 on that one. Customer tipped me $3. So I made $8 on a Chipotle order. They don't take out taxes. So you want to be careful of that. And like I said, some weeks are better than others. Like last week, I don't know if you can see this, but last week I made more than I've ever made. I made $472.63. So if we go into that, then it tells me I did 66 orders for the week. My dash time was 27 and a half hours. And my active time was 22 hours and almost 15 minutes. My DoorDash pay for the week was $254.75, and my customer tip was $217.88. Now, the DoorDash pay also includes your peak pay hour, your base pay and your peak pay hours, peak pay money, whatever, dollars. So that's the earnings, and then you can go into your ratings, And here's my ratings for the week. Hopefully you can see that there's not much glare. I'll go ahead and read this off in case you can't read that. So the average customer rating, the top rating is a 5. So I'm at 4.83. So customers really like how friendly I am, how on time I am, punctual, whatever. My acceptance rate is at 90%, and that's because I have issues with a grocery store. So they keep sending me to that grocery store, and I will not go back to that grocery store because that kind of goes along with the completion rate. You want to make sure that your completion rate is up, because if you're below 80%, as you can see, you could be deactivated. And we all know back in July, I was deactivated through no fault of my own. So you want to try to keep your completion rate up, and your on time or early is a little bit low, but that's because sometimes the restaurant is running a little bit slow on their food orders. So to start dashing, what you want to do is you want to click on the area that you want to dash at, and then you hit dash now. I'm not going to go through all the steps, and then it'll come up with this schedule here, and this tells you every half hour when you want to stop your dash. So then you click on that. I'm not going to do that. And then it'll bring you to another menu that, or another screen that says, do you have enough gas? Do you have your phone charged? Do you have your red card? And do you have your DoorDash bag? So then you click on all those, and then you hit your start your dash. You will get a screen that looks like a Google Maps, and it'll say looking for orders on the top. And once a customer places an order and DoorDash can track you through the GPS, they will send you an order to an area where you're close to. You won't know where you're delivering the order until after you pick up the food. So you could be picking up in one city and driving 20 minutes to drop off the food, and you don't know until after you pick up the food. So you go to the restaurant. You slide once you're there, and then it'll give you the information of the name that you're looking for. Sometimes it'll say what the customer ordered, and you'll have to click on each of the items that they ordered to make sure that you have it. And then it'll say slide that you picked it up, and then it'll give you the address of where you're going. You can do the directions, which I normally do, because then the customer can see where you're at and how close you are to them. DoorDash can send you up to 2 orders at a time, unless you're on a grocery order, at least for this one particular grocery store. This grocery store is horrible. It's Hy-Vee in Plymouth. I have had a couple times where I've actually waited an hour to get the food, and that's because Hy-Vee is not on the ball there, and so they don't send you any more orders. If you're on a grocery order, that's the only order they send you through DoorDash. And you have to wait until you complete the order before they send you another one. So that's why my completion rate and my acceptance rate is so low, is getting lower, because I refuse to go to that store anymore. So so I showed you how to do that. You can make your own hours. So you dash when you want. They do 24 hours a day. It's nationwide. So wherever you're watching from, you can do, most likely, do DoorDash. You have no time clock to click in. You don't have a specific schedule. You can schedule your DoorDashes whenever you want. You don't have to schedule them. You can just go to a location and then start dashing. You can start your dash at home, and then they'll send you locations to go to, and then you've got to make sure that you drive there and deliver the food. And I went through those steps. So things that you want to keep in mind is that DoorDash does not reimburse you for gas. Neither does Uber Eats, and neither does Grubhub. I don't know about other delivery services in other states, but those three food delivery orders, delivery services do not reimburse you for your gas. So you want to keep your gas receipts if you're using your car specifically for DoorDash. You want to keep any receipts for, like, if you have to pay a monthly fee for your phone. If, like me, you have a track phone, keep track of how many, you know, when you have to add time to your phone. Any maintenance you have to do on your car, if you need new tires, an oil change, something happens with your car, make sure you keep those, because at the end of the year for taxes, because they don't take taxes out, you're going to have to save money for that as well. But all those things can be deductible because you're using your car for your job, because you are an independent contractor. So make sure you keep your fuel receipts, keep your car repair receipts, keep any receipts for use with your phone, anything you use for specifically for door dashing, keep your receipts so that you have them in a specific place, so when you go to do your taxes at the end of the year, you have all that information so that those things can be deducted. And keep track of your mileage. What I have done is when I start my DoorDash, I go into my trip A on my odometer on my car and I zero that out so that every day I know exactly how many miles I'm doing. So what I did is on my phone, I have a notepad. And so what I've done, you can see there's a list here, specific day I DoorDashed, how many miles I drove that day and how much I made for that specific day. I've done that for every single month, April through September. And I update that every single day. So make sure you keep track of your mileage. I keep track of how much I made, even though it's in the DoorDash app that you can go into your earnings, but I just do that for myself. You can do however you want. And of course, make sure that you're wearing your mask and all that stuff. Keep your social distance and that. So at this point, I'm almost at my time here. I set my timer for 16 and a half minutes and it's about ready to go off. So I'm just going to go ahead and pause that. So I'm going to give shout outs to all of you, and I'm going to make this really quick because you know that I can only record for like 18 minutes and 45 seconds, something like that. So if you don't hear your name, please comment below. And if you're watching my video, comment below. Let me know who you are so I can add your name to the list. So Amanda, Danny Diamond, I need to hear from you, Danny. Veronica, Clemen, Silvermist, Andrew, John, Nana, Catherine, Dauda, Doug, William, and Bill, same person. Nipper Girl, Danny Sierra Lynn, Tom, Rob, Carolyn, Kelly, Nolan, Autumn Shade Silent Paw, not sure if you're still watching, Megan, Allison, Zimmertrax, Stevens, Bold Servant of Jesus the Christ, Social Bounty, Make Money App, and Sam Bierke. So there's all my shout outs of all the people that I know. I know I have 39 people, but that's not 39 people on that list. So I need to know who you are so I can add you to the list. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and let you guys go. Again, if you have any other questions about DoorDash, how it works, how to sign up. Right now, they are offering Dashers an $1,800 sign-on bonus for every referral. And when I first started, it was like $100, $150, so they are desperate for Dashers. So if you want to become a Dasher, let me know in the comments below. Let me know how to get in touch with you privately, because I'll need your phone number so that I can send it into DoorDash and they can send you an invite. And then once you start dashing and you can get people signed on, then you can make that kind of money too. But you the Dasher has to put in, I think, 30 days or something like that of dashing before the Dasher that referred them gets paid. So in any case, I'm going to go ahead and let you go before my video turns off. You guys have a sunny day, and we'll see you on the next one.